just prior to the collapse of the dairy crisis.
And so what you were really sort of showing to us is that rates were an iniquitous tax. There were a tax on capital that, and we're bound by that horrible thing called legislation, sort of going forward. And
well, it's not only tax on capital, is it? Because it excludes plant. You know, I've got a number of friends who operate trucking firms, and they don't pay very much rates at all, do you know?
Our council has traditionally, recognising our farmers, have kept our UAGC as high as we possibly can. I presume Federated Farmers are lobbying our masters in control to have that UAGC changed and become more substantial.
Look, absolutely, and for a number of years, Your Worship, and I find it extraordinary that on the funding side, central government was so encouraging the local government to look after your communities and do this and look after that. And you have free will and power of general competence and everything else. But you can't use your UAGC more than 30%. You limit the property taxes, to suck it up. And they repeatedly come back and say,
means you're buying afternoon tea.
And we sympathise with that challenge. I just don't understand why. I understand the history of the 30% cap, but I just don't see it's fair to St Modern.
And you see that we are up there, and we do use our UAGC to attempt to do any of that balancing. And if we were able to do it, I assure you this council would, in these sort of times, would, which would allow us to move and to get the balance, irrespective of whether urban goes up or rural goes up. It's a balancing nature that is denied to us.
Mm.
And despite local governments saying, hey, we would like to have that general competence to recognise it, that is a way forward if we could actually better use the UAGC. Mm. Councillor?
To you, Mr. Mayor, I've on record in this council for not supporting a rate increase that would have an effect of 10% or more on our dairy farmers. And every which way I looked to try and see whether this council is doing its level best, however, to keep rate increases to a minimum. But I couldn't concur with you enough that the system, as it's shown this year, is totally inequitable and totally, in my view, totally wrong. I probably have a minority view on this around this table. But one of the things that occurred to me is that the mayor has been fond of suggesting that we shouldn't be having a differential rating. But I don't know whether the Federated Farmers have done any research on sort of that type of rating to whether we, under the UAGC, whether we can in fact, there are probably areas of which could be added onto the UAGC that are not there at the moment. So I don't know whether you've got any comments on that. Or A, whether the UAGC could include some extra areas that are purely urban-based or activities of council. And secondly, whether there could be some differential basis. Now, whether that's in the form of a cap on rates or something of that nature. Have you got any comments on that?
I had a friend who was a regional councillor down in Horizons, and I started talking to him about UAGCs and that, and he says there's a movement down there to try and get some of the targeted rates included in UAGC, and they had some success on that, but unfortunately he died the nitty-gritty of the details. But they have had some success in including more That was at regional council level, not district council level. So, you know, certainly, you know, we would love that to happen. The other thing regarding rates differential, you know, we are just very wary of that because of our political strength, so to speak. You know, I think that for all that you representatives are, you know, you are all representing constituents, and, you know, if push comes to the shove, you know, rurals might just suffer big time, you know, and that's why we are a little wary of going down targeted rates, although it could be if it was
differential
rates,
I think.
Sorry?
Differential
rates. Yeah, just, sorry, yeah. Yeah, so that's our concern about that, you know. So, and that's why it can happen. You know, to us seems a pretty
as we look at CAG, because the differentials, and you will see that in some places in which differentials are disappearing, the business community says we want a differential.
Yes.
And the and have a valid sort of cry for it, and then where do you do it? And in terms of that, recognise that in terms of your friend with regional council, regional councils for many years haven't been using UAGC. Our regional council has only recently introduced it. A few years ago, they didn't have it. Hamilton City doesn't have a UAGC, you know, because they are such a tight urban thing, they do it all on their general rate. So not all councils use the UAGC. And regional councils haven't always been using it. And they've only recently come on board with the UAGC to say, here's those community things. So that's where Horizons, as I looked at that, we're saying, hey, we can use UAGCs. It's a new tool in their basket that wasn't there, that they hadn't picked up. So that, you know, I mean, Auckland, you know, there's a different rating system again. They're using rental values or what therefore takes place. Look, we are very conscious. I assure you that, you know, we will be discussing with our officer when Ben is here, what does this rate capping mean? Does it mean a lower of service? Does it mean moving somewhere else? Because we have cut to the bone, you know, as much as we could. I can assure you, when the first of the drafts came out, the farmers had a 42% increase in value. It was 18-19% as it started there, which this council then hid under their desks, you know, being worried about that. So how did we get this balance? And I'm conscious that a previous mayor used to say, hey, it goes like this, and right now you've got this tough pickies, it's going to go like this. We've just been told that farm values have dropped and our urban values have gone up. If the snapshot for valuation was May 2016, rather than July 2015, we'd have a different picture. You know, now we know that, and so how do you forecast the future that Solomon in all his glory was not able to do that?
Can I just make a point of that, you know, regarding valuations? I bought a property position 1st of June last year. The valuations that council came out with, I bought a tender. I was the highest tenderer, and the guy made me come up even higher than what I tendered, so it was above the market value. The valuation that the District 1 came out higher still, so I objected to it, and they came out and did the valuation. I haven't really heard what the valuation is, but anyway, there were some improvements done to put the two properties together. And I says, those were done in July, so ignore it for the purposes of the May valuation. And he says, oh no, I've got to include it. So here I've got a valuation that includes improvements done after that valuation date that are actually going to be put back into the thing. So it's going to be a future value put back into that 1st of June thing.
Sorry?
We'll follow
that up on you, because we have been assured by the valuer that the snapshot date There's the snapshot date, nothing.
I argued